Tag TV brings you daily news bulletin from India. Breaking news and views from India.
You're watching South Asia Newsline and here are the top stories we are tracking for you on Monday, the 7th of October. Maldives President Mohizud expresses gratitude to PM Modi for 30 billion rupee support. Pakistan voiced concerns on its strategic position amidst Israel-Iran tensions. And Iran plans to deport 2 million Afghan citizens by 2025. Human rights groups raise concern. And now for all the details. Maldives President, who is on a five-day visit to India, on Monday described India as a key partner in the socio-economic and infrastructure development of the country. The President thanked Indian Prime Minister Narendra Modi for Indian government's decision to provide support in the form of Rs 30 billion in addition to 400 million bilateral currency swap agreement. Describing the development partnership as an important pillar of New Delhi-Male ties, PM Modi asserted that India has always given preference to the priorities of the people of Maldives. PM Modi further said that the island country holds an important position in India's neighbourhood policy and Sagar vision. Concerns have grown in recent months that cash-strapped Maldives could become the first country to default on Islamic sovereign debt. Still, sentiment has improved since China and India, which vie for influence in the strategically located archipelago, extended fresh support lines. Modi and Mohizud said India and the Maldives will start talks on a free trade agreement. Maldives-India relations were hurt after Mohizud won power in April and demanded New Delhi replace 80 defence personnel it had stationed on the Maldives with civilians as part of his India Out campaign. But the relationship has been on the mend following diplomatic talks and meetings since.
We look forward to concluding the free trade agreement with India, which will enable us to harness the full economic potential between our countries and to increase Indian investments in both our tourism and various sectors of development.
Doctors in India's Kolkata city agitating over the horrific rape and murder case of a female trainee doctor on Monday announced hunger strike for the next 36 hours after expressing disappointment with the government and the judiciary. However, the doctors in Kolkata have now announced to return to work and said only 6 of them would sit on an indefinite hunger strike until demands are met. The top court in its last hearing had urged the state government to put in place all measures by October 15 to meet the doctors' demands. The doctors' demands include increased police protection in hospitals and an investigation of what they say is corruption in several medical colleges. West Bengal, ruled by the regional Trinamool Congress Party, has been slow to create new tribunals to try sex crime speedily, according to media reports.
रास्ते में डॉक्टर लोग भीग रहे हैं, दादा लोग अनशन कर रहे हैं, अपने जिंदगी को दांव पे लगा के, उसके ऊपर भी अथॉरिटी को कोई भी केयर नहीं है, वो पहले दिन से हम लोगों को दिख रहा है, उसके ऊपर से क्या हो रहा है, पुलिस आके हम लोगों को भी बहुत तरीके से थ्रेट दे रहा है, हम लोगों को यहाँ पे रहने में बहुत सारा बाधा क्रिएट कर रहा है, हमारे जो बाहर टॉयलेट आने वाले थे, पानी आने वाले थे,
And at least 2 Chinese nationals and 1 Pakistani were killed and dozen others sustained injury in a blast near Pakistan's Karachi airport on Sunday night, which the Chinese embassy in Pakistan has described as a terrorist attack. The Baloch Liberation Army has claimed that the explosion was an attack carried out by them using a vehicle-borne improvised explosive device targeting Chinese nationals, including engineers. The BLA seeks independence from the province of Balochistan, located in Pakistan's southwest that borders Afghanistan and Iran. In August, it launched coordinated attacks in the province in which more than 70 people were killed. BLA specifically targets Chinese interest, in particular the strategic port of Gwadar on the Arabian Sea, accusing Beijing of helping Islamabad exploit the province. It has killed Chinese citizens working in the region and attacked Beijing's consulate in Karachi.
जो इनिशियल इतला हुई है वो एक ऑयल टैंकर जो है उसके आग लगने से जो मुतअद्दिद गाड़ियां जो है वो उसकी जद में आई हैं और उससे बहुत सारा कोलेटरल डैमेज हुआ है। उसको हम अभी मजीद असर्टेन कर रहे हैं कि इसमें दहशतगर्दी का एलिमेंट या कोई और एलिमेंट जो है तखरीबकारी का वो किस हद तक है, जिसको हम अभी रूल आउट नहीं कर सकते।
Moving on, as tensions escalate between Israel and Iran, the potential repercussions for Pakistan have become a topic of heated discussion among citizens. While experts suggest that Pakistan may not play a vital role in the conflict, the country's geographical proximity to Iran has raised significant concerns. A report.
Citizens of Pakistan have expressed anxiety about how a potential war could affect Pakistan, which shares a long border with Iran. They said while Pakistan may be unable to take decisive action due to its complex geopolitical relationships, especially its alliances with American interests, the nation will undoubtedly feel the consequences. Unlike the situation during the Afghanistan war, when Pakistan played a supportive role to US forces and the Taliban, the current landscape presents different dynamics, as they said they cannot afford to take sides.
Pakistan करें कि पाकिस्तान का रोल क्या होगा, पाकिस्तान का रोल इसके अंदर कोई वाइटल रोल नहीं होगा, लेकिन हाँ ये बात है कि पाकिस्तान इससे मुतासिर ज़रूर होगा। अगर ऐसी कोई जंग होती है इसराइल और ईरान के दरमियान, तो चूंकि पाकिस्तान ईरान के बिल्कुल बराबर में वाक़ है, इसकी स्ट्रेटजिक पोजिशन जो है वो ईरान के साथ लगी हुई है, लिहाजा उसके असरात पाकिस्तान पर बहुत ज़्यादा होंगे। लेकिन पाकिस्तान भी बाज़ मजबूरियों की अमेरिकन अलाई होने की वजह से कोई बहुत बड़ा इकदाम नहीं कर सकेगा।
Residents also expressed hope that the Pakistan government is prepared for any repercussions, as they say they do not want to be dragged into someone else's conflict again. For days, Israel has been bombing the Beirut suburbs, which are considered strongholds for the Iran-backed armed group, killing its leader Sayyed Hassan Nasrallah and possibly his potential successor.
हुकूमत का जो रद्द अमल होगा वो मुख्तलिफ होगा। हुकूमत अपनी इंटरनेशनल पॉलिसीज़ का तहफ़ करेगी और अवाम जो है अपनी मजहबी या इस्लामी वाबस्तगी की वजह से ईरान की तरफ जाएगी। ये एक बहुत बड़ा जो है चेंज होगा और बहुत बड़ा चैलेंज भी होगा पाकिस्तानी हुकूमत के लिए कि वो इससे किस तरह नबर्दाजमा होती है।
Ahmad Reza Radan, the commander in chief of Iran's law enforcement, has stated that the deportation of Afghan migrants from the country is ongoing and that by the end of March 2025, 2 million Afghan migrants will be expelled from Iran. Radan said over 7,50,000 illegal migrants have already been deported from Iran and this number will reach 2 million by the end of the current Iranian calendar year. He added that this year alone, over 500,000 illegal migrants have been arrested and deported from Iran, and as a result, 2,50,000 others voluntarily turned themselves in and left the country. The mass deportation of Afghan migrants from Iran has raised concerns among human rights organizations, with many calling for a more human approach to the situation. As tensions between Iran and Afghanistan continue to rise over this issue, international bodies are urging both governments to engage in dialogue and find a solution that ensures the safety and dignity of Afghan migrants while addressing Iran's concerns over illegal immigration. Nepal's legal landscape witnessed a significant change this past weekend as Prakash Man Singh Raut officially assumed office as the new Chief Justice. His swearing-in ceremony took place shortly after Nepali President Ramchandra Podel appointed him following a recommendation from the Parliamentary Hearing Committee. The ceremony was conducted at President's office, marking a pivotal movement for the judiciary. In alignment with Article 129, Clause 2 of the Constitution, President Podel confirmed Raut's position as Chief Justice, acting on the recommendation of the Constitutional Council. This development came after the Council convened in September and put forward Raut as a candidate for the prestigious role. As Chief Justice, Raut is poised to play a crucial role in steering Nepal's judiciary toward upholding justice and the rule of law, following a smooth transition in leadership at the apex court. His extensive legal career and commitment to judicial integrity suggest a promising future for the judicial system in Nepal. At least 5 people died and dozens required hospitalization following an Indian Air Force air show in Chennai on Sunday that saw around 12 lakh spectators assemble at Marina Beach. The deaths were caused due to dehydration, media reports said, citing police officials. Thousands of spectators abruptly left the venue after the show, congesting traffic on streets. A government statement said the air show at Chennai's Marina Beach to mark the Air Force Day was attended by 1.5 million people. Questions are being raised over the Indian Air Force aggressively pushing this event to set a Limca Book of World Record by aiming to mobilize 15 lakh spectators, much beyond manageable, and the Chennai City Police poor crowd and traffic management. The Chennai Police had deployed 6,500 police personnel and 1,500 home guards for security. That's all in tonight's edition. We will see you same time tomorrow. Good night.
TAG TV brings you daily news bulletin from India. Breaking news and views from India.